Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to Master Jesus. The Lord bless each and everyone again for joining, for in Jesus' name. The Lord have sent me to warn you about this gentleman. God has sent me to warn you about this gentleman. This gentleman is planning to disgrace you. This gentleman is planning to expose you. This gentleman is planning to knock you down in the name of Jesus. I want to use this medium opportunity again once more to welcome each and every one of us to prophetic blessings in the name of Jesus. If this is your first time, you're very much welcome. The Bible says in the presence of God, praise Master Jesus, this is something that only comes from within. And I believe you watching this prophetic word, the smile on your face alone is a key that will open doors of joy in the name of Jesus. I want to plead with each and every one of us. This is your first time. Become part of this great family. Become my friend, my personal friend, my prayer partner. I believe in the word of God, in God demonstration power. As you're subscribing, you're liking, may the good Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. And this particular prophetic word, the Lord says, I should warn you about this gentleman. Praise Master Jesus. Our God sees the end of a thing than the beginning. This remind me on a particular incident that happened so many years backward. There is a lady today that cannot see because of such things, similar things. Praise my, what I'm about to reveal on this prophetic word, this is actually what I've seen countless times in the life of people. The other day I was live, a lady was telling me that one of her friends promised to marry a guy. This guy sponsored this lady 3 years in the university. When this lady graduated, this lady fell in love with another guy. And this guy had money. Then the lady calculated all the money this guy spent for him. The lady counted the money, came and gave it to this guy. Say, I'm sorry, you are not my spec. I cannot marry you. I'll just come to pay you back your money. So this guy was like, after everything I've done to you, is this the way you're gonna pay me? Then this guy told the lady that I will not take the money. This guy was so angry. Then this guy organized a particular small program. Then the guy called the lady and said, okay, I've forgiven you, bring back my money. So the lady was coming to give back this money with thinking that everything's okay. Then this guy told the lady that for me to take this money and let you go, we must have sex together one for the last time. Then I take my money, then you go. So this lady now said, okay, like, because the lady knew, because the new guy knew that this was her ex-guy. And this new guy gave this lady money to give this guy. So, you know, as women are. So this particular lady went to do what this guy asked him. So they went to do it together for the last time, not knowing that this guy has planned to do something to this girl. The moment they entered the house, the guy shut the door, removed a machete, butchered this girl. Kill this guy in the broad daylight. Though this guy went to jail for murder, but you have lost your life. Secondly, incident that happened. Oh my God. Let me know, because this is a life story. This is a true life story. Praise Pastor Jesus. So I saw a lady that could not see. And all her face was burned with acid. Then one day I was sitting somewhere. I was like, wow, a beautiful girl with like the shape. When you look at the girl, the height, the shape, everything, the figure, this lady had, the accent, the voice and everything, but the face has been boring. Then I sat someday, I was hearing a story. People were discussing, one man said, look at this lady. Then someone showed the picture of this girl when she was not yet in that condition. I said, ah, are you sure this is the girl? They say yes. Then they began to share the story. They said this girl was dating a guy. And this guy sponsored this lady. At a particular point of marriage, this lady told this guy that she cannot marry this guy. This guy could not bear the shame. He could not bear the pain. And this guy went and bought acid. Oh, some people can be wicked. If it's me, I just hand you to God. I just come and pray. My tears will speak for you. This guy went and bought acid. But as it invited the girl, like the lady said no, like blah blah blah, because the lady was seeing a different man. So I don't know what happened. To cut the long story short, this guy invited the girl over. This girl came, like when they were trying to talk, this guy said, come, let's talk, let's sort the issue out. The moment at night when they were sleeping, this guy removed the acid, pour it out on the face of this lady. That's how the face of this lady burned. Her intention was to spoil the beauty of this girl. So they took this girl to the hospital. It was not really easy. The young lady almost blind. So they opened an investigation. The investigation shows that they arrested the guy. Then the guy said, I did this because of this. And all the proofs were there. But the law does not permit the guy to take that type of action. So they had to sentence this guy in prison. I think it was about how many years? Maybe about 10 years imprisonment. But this lady's face has never been beautiful. The face has burned, the eyes everywhere twist because of the behavior of that girl. So I've heard a lot of things. You watching me, you have your own part. You have your own story to also tell. Maybe more beautiful or more sweet or more visible, more transparent than my own. But listen to me. The reason why I brought up all this story is for us to link it to this particular prophetic word. Our errors of yesterday, we correct it. We correct our yesterday errors, not to suffer it tomorrow again. Our seed of yesterday is a harvest of today. So if we have seen errors of others and see the end of their errors, that means we need to correct it today. So this particular prophetic word is talking about this gentleman. The Lord says, I should warn you. There is a lady that I'm seeing, a gentleman planning to disgrace you in public. Disgracing you in public is that they will do something to you that you will never live to tell. A trap has been placed in public for you to be disgraced. And this disgrace will lead to your death. And this particular person is someone that he has been spending money on you. But right deep in you, you know that your heart is not with him. The Lord is revealing to reveal. God revealed to redeem. If you do not love a man, please don't eat his money. If you do not love a man, don't promise him marriage. If you do not love a man, no matter how he loves you, don't allow him spend money on you. The moment you love a man, the moment you allow a man to spend his money on you, is a risk. Because a man spending money on you is a risk. It's an altar that he is raising. Praise Master Jesus. And we also, as the men also, I want to talk to us men. When a woman loves you, it shows. Love is not just by words alone, by action. If a woman loves you, you will see through their action. If a woman loves you, see through their action. Please, may I plead with each and every one of us, wherever you're watching or connecting, as a man, do not force yourself on a woman that don't love you. Most of the time we blame women, we also, the men, we just force them. If a woman say no, don't love you, don't force yourself. Let her go. Wait for your woman jeep to come and meet you. You also, as a woman, if a man does not love you, you don't love a man, don't eat. Like, let us cultivate. The generation of which we are living inside right now, I don't really understand. When you see two couples in a relationship, one of them is there for something. Either one is there to eat money, one is there to joke, one is there. One person must be fake. Why must one person be fake in the relationship? In those days, our parents were genuine. Now, two couples cannot be together without like doing something without court marriage. But in those days, our parents never knew something like court marriage. They could meet together. When a man said, I love you, the love was genuine. Our parents could stay together, love each other. They could walk farm. They were not even praying. They were not doing anything. But they could just carry water, speak word on their mouth, and it will work. Our generation. Lies. Fake lies telling. Our generation only lie. What we know to do best is to tell lies. We can tell lies. The same mouth you used to tell lies is the same mouth you want to invoke spirit. How will it go? God cannot trust you. Can God trust you? May the Lord bless us for in Jesus' name. Amen. This prophetic word, can we take it back to our sacred place? Everybody take it back. If you know you are into a relationship that is not from your heart, the man you don't love, the girl, quit. Say no. The girl you don't love, the man, say quit. Put an end. Separate yourself. Hallelujah. Put an end. Say no. Say let it end. In the name of Jesus. I pray for someone watching and connecting that may the Lord see you through. May the Lord see you through, family, for in Jesus' name, amen and amen.